it's a huge day in Thailand. And for more insight, Harrison Cheng joins us, director at Control Risks, and he's live. Harrison, Parliament has already begun their session to elect a new prime minister after two failures last month. And Pheu Thai's Setta Thaksin is on course for the role, needing just 58 votes more. How do you see Thaksin's return earlier today help him?
Well, I think Thaksin is essentially the price that Pheu Thai has to pay in order for Setta to receive the votes from the Senate today. And I think, you know, Thaksin coming back, the next steps being to essentially serve an 8-year jail term for the three convictions that he has. Essentially, the Senate and the military and the Conservative bloc will be looking to see if Thaksin will honour that 8-year term, or if Pheu Thai might seek to try and amend the laws to let Thaksin go in a more relaxed manner.
Why don't we dive a little deeper on your last point? I mean, the PM vote today, the outcome of which, how could it help him, say, specifically, if Setta Thaksin does win it? And are there any worst-case scenarios that you see?
Well, I think ideally what Pheu Thai will want to do is to ensure that some of the cabinet positions that they have said they would want to claim, I think it's 8 or 9 ministerial posts, will include those ministries, for example, Home Affairs, the Interior, as well as Justice Ministries. And I think that might be contested by the Conservative partners who, if you will recall, now have a larger number of seats compared to Pheu Thai's 140 over seats. And so if Pheu Thai is able to control those ministries, they might very well start to try and meddle in the judicial system to ensure that Thaksin perhaps can get off with fewer years in prison. It could be that Thaksin's medical issues then allow him to serve out his jail term in more comfortable settings in a hospital, for example. But I think there are certain outcomes today that could still be negative and detrimental to Pheu Thai and to Setta, even though Thaksin has already landed in Thailand. And the reason for that is because on the currently right now, the parliamentary debate is turning into essentially an interrogation of what Pheu Thai would do or what Setta would do once he becomes prime minister. And I think the Senate is using this very opportunity to start to pin down Pheu Thai, to say things like, no, we will not amend the constitution. No, we will not work with Move Forward in the future, even after the Senate's term expires next year. And I think Pheu Thai knows very well, if it does not adhere to these conditions today, in the next few hours, there's a chance that Setta could be rejected. And based on the precedent that was set by Parliament regarding Peter Lim Jaunat, there's a chance that Setta could be rejected and someone else will have to take his place at the next parliamentary vote.
I see you've thought of all the possibilities that could scupper Setta's chances and Pheu Thai's chances today. But honestly, what do you foresee in today's parliament vote? Will Setta and Pheu Thai win it?
I suspect that Setta would win it. I think Pheu Thai would agree to all these concessions. I mean, and I base this not really on any kind of insider knowledge of Pheu Thai, but really on what Pheu Thai has shown is willing to do in the past few months, ditch Move Forward, for example, backtrack on its policy to amend the Les Majest Law, for example, link up with Palang Pracharat and the United Thai Nation Party. And Pheu Thai cannot be so naive to think that, doing this would not simply embolden the Conservatives and the Senate to basically ask for whatever they want. And if Pheu Thai has gone so far, why would they not take the final step of saying, yes, we would seek to amend the constitution, but we would hold a referendum, we would need to consult the Senate. And who knows, those could take years, those could take 3 or 4, or even take until the next election to happen. And so in a sense, Pheu Thai could make those promises and the Conservative bloc would agree to back Setta today.
Harrison, I want to talk a little bit about the mood among Thai people today now that Thaksin's return actually happened. We saw a lot of his supporters, but then there are people who are still angry with his return, compounded, of course, with the views of those who wanted a change in government with the Move Forward party. You're a risk expert. Tell us, what risks are associated with this long political deadlock?
I think, of course, Move Forward supporters are unified in that they do not want Pheu Thai to form a government with the pro-military parties. And so we've seen that outrage manifested in protests in Bangkok. Nevertheless, Thaksin's return complicates the picture for Pheu Thai supporters and the red shirts, who have long been Thaksin's, or rather Pheu Thai supporters as well. The reason that of that being that although Pheu Thai working with the military infuriates many of the red shirt supporters, Thaksin's return could possibly placate quite a number of them. There's one key Pheu Thai leader, Nathawut Saikwa, who is a red shirt leader, who has since decided to step down from his role in Pheu Thai, stating that, you know, it is because of Pheu Thai's involvement with the military. However, he has also said that he wishes that Setta would become prime minister. He wishes to see Pheu Thai form the government. And that's really a very delicate balancing act of accepting that now Thaksin is back is actually good for Pheu Thai and the red shirts, even though it comes with that package of having to work with the military. I think because of this division within the Pheu Thai red shirt camp, we're not going to see major protests, or rather protests that are far greater and far more disruptive than those we've seen so far in Bangkok. I think Move Forward supporters will continue to be galvanized to protest against Pheu Thai, against the Senate and the Conservatives. But I don't see Pheu Thai supporters supporting them en masse because of the fact that, well, they have got what they asked for a long time, which is Thaksin back in Thailand.
All right. Thank you very much. Harrison Cheng speaking with us live. He's director at Control Risks, speaking with us in Singapore.